Ladies and gentlemen, Gungans, Druids, Ki-Adi Mundi, Conans across our beloved empire, thank you so much for stopping by the biggest and deadliest Star Destroyer and spending a part of your day with me, where we are going to be discussing some huge changes to Grand Arena matchmaking. And as a result, we're going to be, a lot of us are going to start placing more teams on defense. And as a result of that right there, we are going to be seeing a widening of the Grand Arena meta and making old things that we just don't really see or appreciate as much anymore, like Finn Lead. We haven't talked about Finn Lead in ages, how things like Finn Lead, Ewoks, Mo Money, Mothma, and a lot of teams in that range of viability are gonna become extremely important. Old teams becoming more important in Grand Arena is going to be huge. And on top of that, matchmaking for hopefully a lot of you guys out there is going to be getting better as well. We're coming fresh off a Grand Arena season. Hopefully your domination was on a whole other level, baby. And now we're going to be going to 3v3 Grand Arena. And you may have heard me dabble on this topic throughout past couple Grand Arenas, saying that, you know, their Grand Arena change is coming. Some teams are just going to become more important than others. Never got a chance to make a video on the official announcement of this because I was gone on my honeymoon last month. But now I want to bring this topic up because the developers have given us an additional update that I was waiting for, because I heard through the grapevine before it was confirmed that there are going to be some additional changes to these changes they announced last month, and we officially have it. Long story short, what I want to start off with first, and the reason why we have this new update today, is last month when they announced these changes, firstly, they were going to be dividing up the divisions a little bit more. So Division 11, you have to have 0 GP. Division 10 is going to be 1 million GP starting. Division 9, 1.6 million. You can see the division changes are different than what they were in the past, which basically means, long story short, that they were going to try to match up with people more closely related to what your roster looks like, which is great. That's what we want. We don't want people milking the matchmaking system and stomping on people who maybe have a little bit wider of a roster. So this is kind of nice to see that these, in a hypothetical sense, should make matchmaking better. But the other important thing here was, depending on what division you were going to be in, you were going to possibly require the same amount of teams, less teams, or more teams. So here we go. For divisions 1, 2, through 4, 5, and 6, you were going to need more teams on defense. As you see here, for example, this new Division 1, which I'll be a part of, is over 7.8 million GP, the peak of the peak competition. I'm going to start needing 4 more teams on defense, and as a result, I need 4 more teams in offense. We'll talk about the implications of that. But some divisions were possibly going to have less teams to fight, or less teams to place on defense. As a result, less teams to fight. And there's pros and cons to that. For example, originally, if you had 2 fleets on defense, you perhaps were going to only need 1 fleet on defense. But they made an update not too long ago. We're going to see another forum post soon. But CG, SB Crumb, one of our community managers over here in the Galaxy of Heroes Hala table, announced on the SWGOH Events Discord server that there are no divisions that are going to require less teams on defense. So with these changes, besides division GPs being different, there is no longer going to be an option if you're in a low division that you might require less. One of two things is going to happen. Either you're going to require the same amount of teams on defense or more. So if you were one of those people excited to have less teams on defense, that is no longer going to be an option. As we see right here, there's going to be a forum post coming soon, but they haven't gotten around to it just yet. So we're going to talk about this a little bit earlier before the official forum post comes up. But the reason why they're doing this is because a lot of people are complaining that if you're placing less teams on defense, well, you don't have as many teams to fight. And a lot of people want more teams to fight, to chase after feats, to get the rewards and getting the championship score that they want. So we're going to be requiring either the same amount or more. So that's pretty much the long story short when it comes to this post here. And again, these will be implemented in the upcoming Grand Arena season that's going to be having a 3v3. So now what I want to do, now that we have this out of the way, that the matchmaking is going to be different because of the GP changes, and man, you're going to need more teams on defense, or at least the same amount. This is the part I want to talk about now, because this is huge. Grand Arena, the matchmaking hasn't changed. The amount of teams, I mean, ships was really the only new change that, you know, just a couple months ago, fall of 2020, we needed to add a second fleet because we were getting more and more capital ships and fleets, and we weren't required to put as many things on defense. But now we're going to be seeing this second change to the defensive placement here by adding more teams. And there's two implications as a result of this. I want to talk about implication number one. Bring me over to the game. Someone, thank you. Implication number one, now that we're going to need more teams on defense, the first thing is you're going to start seeing teams that have phased out of the Grand Arena meta. Because really, as of now, the Grand Arena meta Because again, hypothetically, you want to one-shot everything. And we're talking about just characters right now. When it comes to characters, you only need what? If you're playing in the very end of Division 1, you need 7 teams on defense, right? Yeah, 7 teams on defense and 5v5 and 7 teams in offense. So you're really only looking at the top 14, 15 teams at most inside of Galaxy of Heroes. Well, now that you need 4 more teams on defense and offense, now we're looking at a much bigger Grand Arena meta. You are widening this branch to start taking in other good teams. Maybe they're not top 15, but they might be maybe top 20, top 25 teams in Star Wars Galaxy Heroes. And that is where we start looking at teams like this. Balanced Tactics with Finn. I'm going to call it now. This is going to be one of those teams. They're going to be huge, whether for offense or defense, because now that we're going to need more things, you need to have more tools in your arsenal. Because things like, for example, Newt Gunray, Lead Count Dooku, we might see those teams come back on defense. I want to talk about Newt Gunray specifically in a moment here. So Finn with the massive turn meter gains and paired up with the OG Poe trying to get as much turn meter as possible running through opponents. I'm going to call now. This is going to be an important team if we're going to start placing more teams on defense. Another team that we really don't see as much unless you're in a very, very low division, Ewoks. Ewoks used to be free banners as the metas got more powerful and Grand Arena, and people stopped putting Ewoks in defense because it was free banners for Ness. Well, now that you're stretching your roster out more, things like Ewoks are probably going to become a lot more important. Jawas. Now, you guys see, we always love to have Jawas around here. Jawas are going to be important because now we might start seeing Geonosians more on defense. Geonosians are getting phased out of defensive viability because they're kind of easy money for a lot of teams out there. Well, if you have to stretch out your roster more, oh man, you might not be able to use your Vader on the Geonosians or your Imperial Troopers or your Bounty Hunters. Jawas are going to be kind of an important team out there. There, the list kind of goes on and on and on. Teams that we aren't really seeing on defense anymore. Heck, I don't want to get too carried away, but the Trash and Orange has been so trash because they are definitely not a top 20 team in Galaxy of Heroes. But if you have to start stretching your roster thin and people are finally getting to that last team and it's Mandalorians and it's like, oh man, I don't have a lot of stuff left over. Things like Mandalorians could see an increase when it comes to Grand Arena viability. Because when we're evaluating new teams and characters, we're really looking at those top 15 teams out there. And if you are outside the top 15 realm, we consider you to be useless. So this is a faction I really want. I don't want to get carried away and say it's going to be great in Grand Arena moving forward, but it's probably going to be at least more important than it is now because we're going to start needing more teams on defense. Then we can kind of go on and on. Night Sisters, kind of a team I don't really see in Grand Arena defense anymore. It might be needed moving forward. The other important implication, I said Newt Gunray a few moments ago, the other important implication is now that we're needing more teams on defense, we're going to see a lot less hybrid teams out there because you don't want to start putting together too many good leaders on a team. And I want to pull up Newt Gunray, for example. So again, this is a couple years ago, back in, my goodness, 2019, when Newt Gunray got reworked and Count Dooku. This was a very important either defensive or offensive team when it came to Grand Arena. But as we started getting more teams into the game, more characters and more powerful characters, Galactic Legends, things like Newt Gunray lead really weren't that important. So people started creating hybrid teams, that being putting Geonosians with Grievous or Newt Gunray is very popular with General Grievous. I think moving forward, you're going to want to not put as many leaderships inside of a team because now you need more teams out there. So Newt Gunray might be being pulled out of General Grievous and we might be going back to a standard Separatist droid lineup that had Droidica inside the mix. Because right now in Grand Arena, there are some really crazy hybrid teams, whether it's Galactic Legends putting in Jedi Revan, General Anakin Skywalker, Jedi Luke, or with Rey, some people just put some of the most powerful light side characters together. I think we're also going to be seeing less hybrid teams as a result and kind of going more to the cookie cutter teams. There's pros and cons to all that. The pros are, well, we could start enjoying Newt Gunray lead in the leftover Separatist a little bit more. The cons is, well, it's going to get a little bit cookie cutter, but in some way, hybrid teams, the hybrid meta Grand Arena gets cookie cutter at a point because everyone's placed the same General Grievous teams. Everyone's placed the same Galactic Legends teams. So I think this is mostly going to be a pro because we're going to see the viability of other leaders that are just getting thrown into a fifth slot, another team kind of jump through the roof. So those are really the two biggest implications when it comes to that. Needing more teams. So it's going to bring back old teams back into the fold and making them more powerful than ever before, making your investments in previous characters more useful than they have been in a very long time. Finn is an all right character, but if he's not important for Grand Arena, it kind of sucks a little bit. So this is going to make a lot of those Galactic Legends investments you might be putting in for characters might make them a little bit more popular and more powerful. And I think the last thing to pull out here is we're kind of way past the days where you see someone put trash stuff on defense, like just throwing in some very low gear stuff. I think we're going to come back to that because we're going to think, how the heck Are you going to address all these new squads that you need on offense and defense? And some people, their answer might be just, we're just going to put some garbage Captain Phasma on defense, which should help with getting feats. Because I don't chase for feats in Grand Arena, because especially at my division, I'm facing all the top 10 teams, and I can't use all Mandalorians to get a feat done. So in another way, requiring more teams on defense, as a result, is going to make it a little bit easier to chase after feats, because we might see some less powerful teams on defense to help you knock out those feats. So long story short, I'm excited for these Grand Arena changes. It's going to have to... We've been in a steady momentum and flow when it comes to Grand Arena. Very predictable. It's turned into a science. It's going to be nice to try to re-experiment with Grand Arena once more and discover what is this new Grand Arena meta gonna look like moving forward. In the meantime, thank you guys so much for stopping by. Like, if you enjoyed the video, comment down below on all your thoughts. Are you liking these new Grand Arena changes? Are you okay with not having less teams on defense, but it's either gonna be the same or more? And more importantly, what are your predictions for what teams are gonna come out of the woods and catch people by surprise, because we haven't seen them for years inside of Grand Arena? But the most important thing is, as you're doing all that and hitting the like and subscribing, I need you to say one thing with me, and that's, dang, it's great to be in the Empire today. I'll catch you guys later. Thank you so much for stopping by. Larry, Gary, somebody, roll out that outro. See you guys later. Mwah!